Good afternoon, dear students. So only 16 students were joined at the class. We have to start the class now. So we are finished up to exercise 1.2 and also theory class of exercise 1.3. I have told you to solve 1.3 exercise. Everyone solved it or not? Exercise 1.3. Okay, we'll try to solve that one. Off your speaker, who is that? Right. Okay. Exercise 1.3. So in first exercise, write the following in decimal form and say what kind of decimal expansion each has. So we have to solve this one. So first one, 36/100, we have to divide it first. So 36, so we have to divide by 100. It is not divisible, keep point. So this becomes how much? It is 360. So 360, so 100 threes are 300, what remains? 60, it becomes 600. So 100, 6 the 600, so 0, 0. So write the following in decimal form and say what kind of decimal expansion each has. So which is a which type of decimal expansion is this? Anyone say which type of decimal expansion? Therefore, 36 divided by 100 is equal to 0.36 is a terminating decimal expansion. Terminating decimal expansion, because its remainder is 0 finally. So it is a terminating decimal expansion. So if decimal after dividing remainder is not 0, then it is a non-terminating recurring decimal expansion. Okay. So you can solve similarly remaining. Okay, you can take the screenshot of this to make a note. See, in the same way, second one, 1/11, it means 1 is divided by 11, it is not divisible, so 0 point, it becomes 10. Again, it is not divisible. Keep 10, then it becomes 100. 11 nines are 99. So what it becomes? 100. So again, it is not divisible by 11. Keep 0. Okay. Then it becomes 100. 11 nines are 99. This is 1. 10, so 0, again it here 10, 11, 9, so 09, 09, 09 repeats. Therefore, 1/11 is 0.09. Therefore, given गिवन रैशनल नंबर गिव्स नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग recurring decimal expansion. Okay, so I solved both the type. So this is the terminating decimal expansion. Another one is non-terminating recurring decimal expansion. So in if any number is of the form p by q, like this is of the form p by q, then it is always expressed in the form of decimal expansion or of the type terminating or non-terminating recurring decimal expansion. Okay, so from the first main I solved only two, remaining you have to solve and make a note of it. Okay, we'll move to second question. You know that 1/7, so 1/7 is 0.142857. okay, can you predict what the decimal expansion of 2/7, 3/7, 4/7, 5/7, 6/7 are without actually doing the long division? If so, how? So here, see, this one thing is already they have given, but they asked to find 2/7 without actual division. We have to predict the decimal expansion of this. For this, we need to split this one. So 2 into 1/7. So this is 2 into 0.142857. Okay. So if you multiply this with this, so what it becomes? So 2 7s are 14, carry 1. 2 5s are 10, 1 11, carry 1. 2 8s are 16, 1 17, carry 1. 2 4s are 8, 1 9, 2 1s are 2.0. So these are the decimal expansion of this 2/7. In the similar way, we can solve for 3/7, that is 3 into 1/7, that is equal to 3 into 0.142857. okay, so this will give you 3 7s are 21, carry 2. 3 5s are 15 plus 2 17, carry 1. 3 8s are 24 plus 1 25, carry 2. 3 2s are 6 plus 2 8. 3 4s are 12, carry 1. 3 1s are 3 plus 1 4. So this is the decimal expansion occurs while dividing 3/7. Similarly, yourself solve for 4/7, 5/7, 6/7. Okay, will you remind? All of you understood or not?
Yes sir.
Right, so do the remaining in the exercise 1.3 second main. So we'll move to third exercise, third question. Express the following in the form of P by Q, where express the following in the form of P and Q, P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0. So we have to express this 0.6 in the form of P by Q. So for this, I have to solve second one. Okay, second one, remaining already solved. Remaining type we already solved. Remaining type we already solved in the examples before class. Okay, so here only 7 as bar, it means 7 only repeats. First term is not repeating here. So express this in the form P by Q. Solution, let x is equal to 0.47 bar, that is x is equal to 0.477777 dash dash dash. Call this as equation number 1. Multiply, so non-repeating term, it is only one number, that is 4 is not a repeating term. Okay, that's why if we want to shift this point to next after 4, we need to multiply by 10. For the equation number 1, we have to multiply by 10 on both sides. What we get? 10x is equal to 4.7777 dash dash dash. Call this as equation number 2. Okay. After this, again, if you want to multiply, so one repeat adagunu kuda 777 point beku. That's why I am multiplying again with. I want to shift one more shift to right side. So yes, multiply by 10 to equation number 2 on both sides. Therefore, 10 into 10 is 100x is equal to, this becomes 47.7777 dash dash dash, equation number 3. Now we can subtract both the equations 2 and 3. Subtract equation 3, equation 2 from equation 3 alli 2 na kalibek. So 100x minus 10x is equal to 47.7777 minus okay 4.7777 dash dash. Okay, so after this, 100 minus 10 is 90x. Okay, 47 plus 0.7777 dash dash dash, okay, minus of 4 plus 0.7777 dash dash dash. Okay, this is equal to 90x is equal to, see here, 40 and this minus 4, 47 minus 4. You can write one more step, 47 plus 0.7777 dash 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 minus 4, minus into plus, minus 0.7777. okay, so minus 0.777 plus 0.77 get cancel. 90x is equal to 47 minus 4 is how much? That is 43. So x is equal to 43 divided by 90. So this is of the form P by Q, where Q not equal to 0. We expressed 0.47 in the form of P by Q. Is it right? Yes. Take the screenshot. Dear student, after the class session, live session, you can also watch the video of this class in TeachMeet app, as well as I have created my channel in YouTube. You can also watch there.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So. Fourth one, solve the remaining two, first and third. Okay, for fourth main, express 0.9999 in the form of P by Q. Are you surprised by your answer? With your teacher and classmate, discuss why the answer makes sense. See here. 0.9999 we have to solve. We have to write this in the form of P by Q. Let x is equal to 0.999... call this as equation number 1. So here no any non-repeating term, so you can directly just multiply by 10. Multiply 10 multiply by 10
I will show you how it
side of equation 1 we get 10x is equal to 9.9999 and so on. Equation number 2, subtract equation 1 in equation 2. So 2 only 1 na subtract madbeku, that is 10x minus x is equal to 9.9999 minus 0.9999. So here we have 10x minus x is 9x, that is equal to 9 plus 0.9999... minus 0.9999... So minus 0.999 plus 0.999 get cancelled. 9x is equal to 9. So x is equal to what? Notary. Nanu odda geno on tartaglila yak surprise aktivanta vicharamadidvi. But now we are actually surprised with this answer. Is it right? Surprise answer lilo x value 1 bandaga.
Yes, sir.
Why? So see, 0.999999
yes, sir,
is nothing but it is very nearest value of 1. It is the very nearest value of 1. That is
one.
X is equal to 1.
One.
Okay. So exactly it is not x equal to, so 0.9999 is not exactly 1 because here is it is the nearest value of 1. So because of it is repeating to infinity, it becomes 1. Okay.
Yes, sir.
And one more thing you have to know about this is, one is also be written in the form of P by Q, that is 1 divided by 1 is again 1, right?
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay, we'll move to next concept, that is what can, so you can take the screenshot of this one. We'll move to next. Okay, I'm going to solve next one. What can be maximum number of digit be in the repeating block of digits in the decimal expansion of 1 divided by 17? So how many decimal numbers of block are repeating in this 1 divided by 17? They are asking. Perform the division to check your answer. Okay, so adanna check madbekantandre en madbeku ni ivaga 1 17 inda divide madu, you have to divide 1 with 17. Solve madtirala after solving.
Yes sir.
Repeating block yavudu anta helbeku, decimal repeating block yavudu anta helbeku. Okay,
yes sir.
Look at several examples of rational numbers in the form of P by Q, Q not equal to 0, where P and Q are integers with no common factors other than 1, and having terminating decimal representation. Can you guess what property Q must satisfy? See, in several examples of rational numbers in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers. So anyone this on their speaker, Bhumika Rathod, please off your speaker. Right. Look at the several examples of rational numbers in the form P by Q, where P and Q are integers with no common. Siddharth, off your speaker. Integers with no common factors other than 1 and having terminating decimal representations. Can you guess what property Q must satisfy? Here only they have given, see here, where P and Q are integers with no common factor other than 1 and having terminating decimal representation. Can you guess what property Q must satisfy? Q must satisfy the property of what? Prime number, or it satisfies the property of co-prime number. It should be the co-prime of another P. So P and Q should be co-prime. See here, where P and Q are integers with no common factor other than 1 means it is a co-prime number. P and Q are co-prime number. And having terminating decimal representations, can you guess what property Q must satisfy? Means Q must be a prime number. Okay, Q must be a prime number. Then only we say it becomes a repeating block. See here in the first example, so 1 by 7, so in 1 by 7, 1 is the common factor of both the numbers and it gives a repeating block. Okay, in 2 by 7 we have answers, in 2 by 7 we have 0.29714 is the repeating block. It means 2 and so 7 are co-prime numbers and 7 is a prime number. 3 by 7 are co-prime numbers and 7 is the prime number. If P and Q, please listen carefully. Surama, off your speaker. Don't on your speakers while explaining. If I asked you, means you can on your speaker and say your answer. Okay. Otherwise, no need to on your speakers. Right. So it concludes that if any number of the form P by Q should be a non-terminating and recurring, then it must be a then P and Q are should be co-prime and Q must be a prime number, then only it is a it gives a non-terminating but recurring decimal expansion. So this is the explanation about sixth one. Okay, we'll move to next. Write three numbers whose decimal expansion are non-terminating, non-recurring. Non-terminating, non-recurring means we can say one number x1, so non-terminating, non-recurring. 10, 100, 1000, 140 ... So here no number is repeating. In the first it is 10, next it is 100, 1000, 10,000. So no one number is repeating again and again. So this is the non-terminating, non-recurring. I will write x2 is equal to 0.23 123 1234 12345 and so on. So here also no number is repeating. So such type decimal expansions are non-terminating and non-recurring. You can write three more examples for the seven main. Find three different irrational numbers between the rational numbers 5 by 7 and 9 by 11. So 5 by 7 matte 9 by 11 madhyadalli irthakkantaha, you 5 by 7 and 9 by 11 antandre they are the rational numbers because they are of the form P by Q. So rational numbers are not an irrational numbers. Okay, so we have to write three different irrational numbers between these two numbers. For that 5 by 7, first we have to solve 5 by 7. 0 point, so it becomes 50, 7 sevens are 49, 1 remains, okay, that becomes 10, 7 ones are 7. Wait, dear students. So 7 ones are 7, 3 remains 30, 7 fours are 28, 7 fours are 28, 2 remains, so 2 means 20, 7 twos are 14, 6 remains. 7 8s are 50.
6, sir.
7 8s are 56. 4 remains. 7 5s are 35. 5 remains. Again, this string is repeating. Okay, this string is repeating. So for 9 by 11, what the answer? 0.90. 11 8s are 88. 1 remains, that is 10. So hello, 2. So 11 8s are 88, 2 remains. 20. 11 1s are 11, 9 remains. 90. 11 8s are 1s are 8s are 1s are, like that. So in between 0.7 and 0.8, we have to write how many irrational numbers? We have to write 3 irrational numbers. These are the rational numbers. We have to write irrational numbers. For that, see here. So x1 is the irrational number. I will write this x1 as 7. Okay, 1. ಇದನ್ನ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ, 5 ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. 715 715 715 dash dash dash. ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸೇಮ್ ವೇ x2 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 0.716 716 716 dash dash dash. x3, ಸೊ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ, 0.7 1 4 2 8 ಇದ್ದದ್ದು 9 ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ, 9. ಓಕೆ, 7 1 4 2 sorry, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇರ್ರ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ನಂಬರ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ದಿ ರ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ here once more I will write x1 is equal to 0.715 6 7 6 0 7 1 5 6 double 0 7 1 5 6 triple 0 7 1 5 6 4 0s, like that we can write one irrational number. Zero point seven one six zero seven one six double zero seven one six triple zero seven one six four zeros and so on. In the same way, third rational number, 72. I will write 720 7200 7200 7240s, and so on. You can write many irrational numbers between 5 by 7 and 9 by 11. In between these two numbers, we can write this non-repeating terms like this. See here, if I write 70 first, this is less than this 5 by 7, that's why I have to move after 1. What it comes, 7 1 becomes here 7 2. 7 2 lies between these two, 0.7 and 0.8, in between 0.8. okay, that's why 7.2 0.72 072 0072 and so on will give an irrational number, because this is not repeating. See here, here it is 72, here it is 072, here it is 0072, here it is 0072, here it is 4072. So it is not a terminating and non-repeating, so it is a irrational number. So in the same way, ninth one, classify the following numbers as rational or irrational. You only classify first one, root 23, whether it is rational or irrational, you have to say and make note in the notebook. In the second one, root 225, is this a rational number or irrational number? Root 225. Anyone say root 225 is a rational number or irrational number?
Irrational number, sir.
It is a rational number. Which rational number it gives?
225.
Which rational number this root 225 give? 15. This is the 15 because root 225 is 15. So 15 is a rational number. So it comes under rational numbers. This is irrational number. This is rational number. And 0.3796. So here decimal expansion terminates. That's why it is also a rational number. Here decimal expansion not terminates, but 478478 non-terminating but recurring. That is also rational number. But in this fifth question, 1.10, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100 rational number. So question number 1 and 5 are irrational numbers, 2, 3 and 4 are rational numbers. Okay.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Today we finished the exercise 1.3. We will start next content 1.4. Content number 1.4. Repeating real numbers on the number. Representation of real numbers on the number line. We will discuss later in the tomorrow class. So today this much is enough. We will continue the repeating real number on the number line in tomorrow's class. Okay, so tomorrow means day, I will notify you. Okay, whether tomorrow is there class or not, I will say tomorrow only. Okay, take care. Yes. Bye bye.
Okay, sir. Bye,
thank
sir.
You, sir. Thank you. Bye. Thank you, sir. Bye.